Yes.
We are able to. We are
So
able
for
to hear
next
you.
2 hours, I want you to forget that you are a professor of so many years, or you have been teaching to the students and all. Just think of about your original days of your college, or maybe while you have initiated your career part of it over there. Okay, so I want you to go to that level now. Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So can I have a look at it, everybody, actually, because I know there are so many kitne participants. We have got more than 40-45 participants into this session, actually. And I'm sure that looking into your list of the participants and your achievements into this career part of it is fantastic, actually. And of course, wherein I'm not able to see everybody's name also, actually, because you have joined with somebody must have joined with the paid names, or somebody must have joined with the full name, actually, also. Yes, I think. Yes, here I'm not going to do any specific, give any lecture or kind of session part of it. It is going to be the interactive session, actually, what I would like to have it. Mr. Jariwala, I would like to take up the name and start looking into that, actually. Mr. Jariwala. Divesh Jariwala. I think he is not there. He has just started the session and he is not there. Fine. I have also requested to form a teams, actually. Holkar sir, can we create a teams, actually? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Holkar sir is listening, sir, to you. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Holkar sir.
Yes, sir.
Can we create a...
yes, sir. I have already shared the team.
Okay. Dr. Suresh Balapandi says that he does not have the camera. Okay, fine. The idea, what I would like to do is that we have got six teams created here, actually. Okay. And these teams are nothing but the six different companies. Hello. Six teams and six teams are going to form a different companies, and wherein they are going to start interacting with me. There are different problems, actually, or different situations of the businesses, a case study, right? So you are not going to be the teachers right now. Now you are going to be the entrepreneurs. You are going to be the industry people, and you are going to start interacting about your business propositions. Can we start our okay, those who are not able to start the camera, rest of the people can start the cameras, actually? No. Also, I would like to start your mics also, speakers also. Reason is that I would be requesting all of you to reach out to the specific rooms and define the rooms, actually. I would like you to define. Okay. Sir, I can start sharing my screen, actually, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Am I visible? My screen is visible to everybody now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Great. So, what we could be doing is that we will be, in next 10 minutes, whatever the 10 groups we have created, this, we will be forming the six groups randomly. I have requested Professor Holkar to create these groups. Then each group is considered as a profit-making enterprise or the business unit, business entity. Okay. And these group members will choose one name of the organization. Maybe XYZ organization, XYZ company, my company name is Strama Summit Machinery. So I'm going to choose that name. Then my organization structure, I do not intend to give the company's organization structure in a brief. Maybe CEO, maybe marketing department, maybe manufacturing department, something like that, in the broader perspective. Then you are going to choose one CEO, one amongst you, whosoever, maybe the 10, 15 people coming together, one you should be able to choose it. Okay. And this team will be defining their products they are going to manufacture, the products they are going to services they are going to, it could be primary business or it could be secondary business or it could be a tertiary business. Now, the moment I'm talking about it, because I know that while dealing with the students, they really do not understand what I'm talking. But now when I'm talking with the seasoned professors and teachers who have been participating in such kind of FDPs and all are very well aware about that actually. So you're going to define about one of your services or a product. This product could be anything. It could be manufacturing of vehicle to the manufacturing of a radiator, or maybe it could be manufacturing of any small if it's electronics, it could be electronics part also actually. So you have to choose amongst, while discussing with you, I have tried to form the group in such a way that every faculty, like mechanical, electrical, electronics, the instrumentation, computer, everybody would be part of that team actually, right? Then you will be choosing one spokesperson from your organization, and one person will keep record of what we have been talking about it over there. Why? Because at the end of the session, one group or the one company will be chosen as the best company from this today's session actually, right? Am I clear? Any questions for anybody?
Yes, sir.
Great. So somebody, now I request somebody from the organizing team to help me out in distributing these six teams or transferring that to the different six rooms. Then I would like six people or the six mentors from the team of the organization team to help all these people over there in defining that. Am I clear? Or if any questions for the participants into that, please ask me actually.
Hello. Sir, we are from different colleges.
I know. You are from different
colleges. We are not sitting in one room. We are sitting in a separate lab, or maybe okay. We are same college, but we are sitting in our sitting room.
Yes.
Then how can we define who is CEO or who is marketing expert or...
In fact, sir, that's what I'm saying. We are going to create a online rooms now.
Okay.
And I have requested Mr. Holkar, sir, to create that online rooms for all of you actually. Okay. So in next 10 minutes, you will be transferred to that room. You will be interacting with each other the way now you're interacting with me, right? I'm talking to Mr. Pandey, sir, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now you and me, we are talking. We have never met each other. You are sitting in some other place. I'm sitting at Nasik at my factory over here, right? So in next 10 minutes, you will be talking. You will be, the basic idea over here is that we are going to create some kind of synergy among the groups actually. Okay. Whatever the topic is very simple actually, and everybody has already established that kind of subject center. Yes, Yashwant sir. Please unmute yourself and...
Hello, sir. Already absent. One round, yes.
Mr. Siva Prasad.
Last round only.
Okay, I think some people, some members have got some problem for the range problem or the data problem is also there. But those things also can be considered by our organizing team in how to accommodate those people over there. Am I right? Mr. Shiv Prasad, sir, I have understood your problem. You have got certain problems related to the data. Am I right? You can raise your hand also.
Sir, you can talk or you can start your chat box. So that
yeah, you can put it into your chat box also. Correct. That is also good. Sir, are we ready? Borse sir or Bhulkar sir, we are ready now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So now I'm requesting everybody to move on to the switch on to the chat rooms where you are going to meet each other. You are going to identify the organization name. You'll be defining your organization structure. And I do not want everything should be perfect, pakka and all. Basically, it's a game actually. It's a game plan actually, right? I would like to involve everybody into that actually. I want to bring everybody onto a common platform now, right? Okay. So can anybody keep the time now? Sir? Now we have got 57 participants. It's good. Good number actually. Vilas sir.
Yes, sir. You please continue.
Yeah. So now, you need to communicate me whether all these people have reached to the rooms. Have they formed that rooms now? Hello.
Essentially, what is expected? We are in through this Zoom platform. So yes. We have to make a group of 6 to 7 candidates?
Yes, exactly. Exactly, madam.
Then how we will make, sir? For example, if I'm writing Nehal, if anyone wants to join my group, I will write in the chat box.
Mr. Holkar, sir, have already created the group and can be transferred to the room, actually.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, sir.
They will be taken to the room. Holkar, sir. Hello.
Sir, you please continue. We have created the group.
Yeah.
Conversation.
No, but I want everybody should be transferred to that rooms actually.
That was not possible right now. It is, we can use only the chat box.
Oh, okay, fine, doesn't matter. Okay, chalo. I think, but now, then in that case, then I will have to change this procedure now. I would like everybody should start responding to me actually in that case, right?
Okay.
Fair. Now I would like to start with this thing again. Okay. Now I got it. I understood. I thought that you are able to transfer them to the different rooms and start this thing actually over there. Okay. Fine. Now, am I visible to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now then probably this rules for the session does not apply here. I was under impression that we can take everybody to the different rooms. And then they can interact with each other and all. Okay, fine. So now each company will have the respond to when. Now here I would like to say that everyone has to respond to me actually, right? The points and all is not a thing over here. Here, I would like to start with a small video clipping. This video clip will be seen by everybody, and I would like to ask a couple of questions based on that actually. Can anybody, everybody see this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Here, what is it all about actually? Can anybody tell me? What
Charlie
is
Chaplin tightening bolt?
Correct. Charlie Chaplin tightening the bolts. Yes. Anybody else has got something, seen something else actually?
So irrespective of the conveyor, all the things are done by the human.
Irrespective of the conveyor, everything has been done by the human. Perfect, sir. Who else is there? Who has seen something else actually into that movie? This is a very old classic movie, 1937 movie actually, if I'm not wrong, right? Modern times. Everybody must have seen this movie actually. Anybody has seen something else into that now movie? One second, I would like to start.
Actually, it is a continuous process that Charlie Chaplin is doing. A continuous
Correct.
Process.
Continuous process. Absolutely. Very true. What else? Again, I'm repeating that. He's bored of it, actually. Have you seen that? He's bored and he's given it to his supervisor. And he's just going it somewhere outside. The repetitive nature of job.
Yes, sir. Very true.
Correct. The repetitive nature of job is creating some kind of boredom for the operators, to the human being, actually. What this gentleman is doing actually here? So what are the options one can think to replace the person into that now? This is a question for you. Another question. In this video clipping, what are the different options where we can think of replacing the person into this?
Automation, sir.
Automation.
Automation is missing.
Okay, by automation
robotics
using.
Robotics and okay. Automations. The robotics we can do that. Robotic arm we can place for
Correct.
Building and screwing the parts in the automation, sir.
Correct.
Like it is there in automobile lines.
Right. Okay. Great. Fantastic.
Pneumatic tools also.
Right. Absolutely. The pneumatic tools could be there. That can be used for applying the torque. Okay. What else there? So now we identified the pneumatic tools or the torque sensors or the torquing unit or wonder robotic. Even this can be also deployed by a person into that, isn't it? So when somebody just mentioned, I'm not able to see individual names actually. Please excuse me for that. But somebody has mentioned about the robotic application, right? Just before robotics, what else could be the another reason or other equipment or the method by which we can reduce the manpower actually into that? Can anybody tell me? You just mentioned, somebody mentioned about the robotic, right? This is perfectly all right. Somebody also mentioned that the pneumatic system or pneumatic tools that can be used, that is also perfectly all right. Somebody also mentioned about the torquing system, the torquing units. But how we can be able to improve upon the productivity and eliminate the manpower into that? Can you give any guess?
Programming or...
Programming. Okay. What kind of programming you can say that actually? Because now I'm talking about two things. One is the removal of the operator dependency and increase in the productivity.
Sir, if we expand this in artificial intelligence, if we on a meditate artificial intelligence, then it will be can be eliminated both the manpower and the
okay. Process. The artificial intelligence probably in our era will be very new for us, right? Because the kind of skill set required for the artificial intelligence or the flow of information and all, that could be the latter stage. But prior to that, anybody can, you can think on that actually, sir. Prior to our artificial intelligence, what has to be done actually? We need to build up the station. We need to build up the system in which the operator can be reduced as well as the productivity can be increased over there, right? And then probably we can think of adopting the artificial intelligence or the IoT, Internet of Things, or the machines talking to each other or the computer robot, and the rest of the things would be coming into that. So the primary phase into the process automation for such kind of things, we will have to have identify the process. What can be automated? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Now, in this, one more important thing, what will be the possibility of, is there any possibility of making mistake by the operator? Let's go to the back, the same example of the Charlie Chaplin doing the torquing, applying the torque, applying the bolts to the product over there, right? Will there be any probability of making any mistakes over there?
Yes, sir, certainly.
Certainly. What kind of mistakes could be happening over there, actually?
Insufficient torque tightening.
Absolutely.
Missing of the
missing of the jobs. Yes. Missing of yes. The torque. Yes, yes. Absolutely. Perfect. Yes. Right. So, in short, when the continuous basis operations are required, then you have to be very careful about choosing the right type of system, right type of process which needs to be automated. Okay. So somebody is going to write down these points. I hope. Holkar sir, right? Now, what you can see that here? Hello? Can anybody tell me what is this actually? This is a typically Ford car manufacturing.
Sir, it is line management.
Line management,
flow.
Correct.
For flow. Assembly correct. Line.
Correct, exactly.
Assembly line manufacturing.
And assembly line manufacturing, perfect.
Because of this, Ford has got international fame and yes. A large manufacturing to all over the world, all over America. Ford car has become a homemaker.
Absolutely. Yes, sir. Can you just tell your name, sir, actually? I'm not able to go through this thing, actually. Hello.
So myself, Professor Rajendra, Osman.
Yeah,
University
Professor Rajendra, fantastic. You absolutely hit the nail, actually, right? So I would like to have a little bit one step ahead of this now. Okay, I would like to go to the next slide where I would like you to just have a look at this film. This is about 1 minute film, 1.5 minute film, which will be describing about the. What you just mentioned about it, it's a assembly line for the Ford cars, right? So I would like to go through that.
ரவீந்திரா மகடியோத்கர் அவரா பிரசன்ட் பண்ணிருக்காரு நான் ஹெச்ஆர் போட்டா தெரியல
sir, presentation is not visible.
Yes sir. Dear all, just wait for 5 minutes. Sir, okay, we will join soon.
Okay sir, okay.
Sorry, I got disconnected from this interactive session actually. Am I audible now?
Yes sir,
you are audible. Yes sir, yes sir.
Right. So, we were just into that specific slide. And we were talking about it, food assembly line. Okay. Here, I would like to start this video clipping. This is another interesting thing, actually, to understand. Have you seen everybody was able to listen this?
Sir, audio was not there.
Audio. Okay. Okay, audio was not there. Huh? Fine. Probably.
Hundred years of the moving assembly line. Now you can.
Are you able to listen this?
1908, Henry Ford introduces the Model T. It costs $850 and takes more than 12 hours to assemble. 1913, Henry Ford installs the first assembly line at the Highland Park Assembly Plant. It's 150 feet long and made of rope. Man hours needed to assemble a Model T drops to 3. 1914, the rope is replaced by a chain. Ford announces the $5 workday, more than doubling workers' salary. Employees can now afford to buy the cars they built. 10,000 workers apply the next day. 1916. The assembly line helps lower prices and drive demand across the country. 1918. Half of all cars on the road are Model Ts. 1927. Ford produces its 15 millionth Model T. 1942. Ford uses its assembly line to produce B-24 Liberator bombers for the United States during World War II at its Willow Run plant. It's the first use of the moving assembly line for aircraft production. 1966. The 10 millionth Ford Mustang rolls off the assembly line. The Mustang is in such high demand, it's built in 3 separate facilities. 1998. Ford becomes the first and only automotive company to certify its plants around the world under ISO 14001, one of the most demanding set of standards of sustainability. 2000. Ford begins the nation's largest industrial redevelopment project at the Ford Roof Center. It has one of the world's largest living roofs, over 10 acres of living plants and a habitat for wildlife. It absorbs 4 million gallons of rainwater every year. 2011, Ford begins to build gasoline-powered, hybrid, and electric vehicles on the same assembly line at its Michigan assembly plant. 2013, about 16 Ford vehicles are built every 60 seconds around the world. The average assembly line runs more than 8 miles, some run more than 20. Ford facilities create 47% less carbon dioxide than in 2000. October 7th, 2013, Ford celebrates the 100th year of the moving assembly line.
I hope everybody has been able to listen back, right? Now, there are a couple of questions from me actually, right? How long it took to build one car in the initial stage actually?
Sir, probably more than 2-3 months, maybe 6 months, one car in the initial stage.
Okay, that is basically the product development. When we have been talking about it, the product life cycle management, PLM, right? You're absolutely right. It takes almost 6 to 8 months or maybe more time also. Now, in this film, they have specifically and categorically mentioned that it is going to, it took so much of time to build one car. Can anybody has listened to that actually? Anybody has listened to this? It specified that it took almost 12 hours to build one car by 150 number of people actually. In the initial stage, when these people introduced the assembly line, they took almost 12 hours to build one car by 150 people. This is one typical one example. Somebody can, you can just note it down. And at the end of that, he also spelled out now in by 2013, after 100 years of manufacturing assembly line automation part of it, they have completed 100 years in 2013, and they have been taking so much of time. What is that time they have been taking for building up one car?
60 seconds.
60 seconds, correct, 60 seconds. This is a very important perspective over there actually. We should be able to keep it in mind. And I would like to just give an emphasis over here. They are the only people who started this world automation. The Ford engineers initiated this world of automation and they introduced that particular into that. There is one more thing, interesting thing you can find it out. When they had a more number of orders, T3 or T15 numbers or whatever the type of vehicle they want to produce, they decided they will be paying $5 per hour to the worker, and they had 50,000 people outside their plant for the jobs. I do not want to go the socio-economical situation of that particular time. But from our perspective, what is important is that the importance of automation and the human being which are involved into that. There is one more thing, interesting thing was also there. During the World War II, what did they change, a major change into their plant? Can anybody tell me?
Sir, that is a... after World War II, I think, sir, little automation and new development in the materials also?
No, definitely. That material development was definitely was a part of the rather integral part of the process, actually. I'm just talking, this question is pertaining to what did major change they carried out during the Second World War?
That was automation, sir. Like mechanization was started, mechanization.
Mechanization was started in beginning of 2009 itself, when they introduced the production line. Okay. This
assembly, assembly line for the planes.
Correct. So they converted the four-wheeler assembly line into the assembly line for the aircraft. What is that actually? The flexibility kind of things, what they introduced into this process has helped them into the changing from car manufacturing to the aircraft manufacturing. This is a very important perspective. We should be able to keep it in mind. I'm just trying to bring it to the evolvement of the assembly automation. I'm trying to bring out the evolvement of the automation and the productive production and productivity kind of things for all of us actually, right? There's one more, the last question I would like to ask you that, what is the speed with which now one can produce the vehicles? That is 60 seconds, right? But he also spelled out on the most important perspective over there, actually. Can anybody just remember about that word called as the, what is that word actually? The least carbon contained, least carbon percentage of
Yes, sir.
Emission, carbon emission. Yeah.
Carbon emission, exactly. And this is a very important perspective as far as the health and safety concerns of the operators are concerned, actually, right? What is that which made the difference into this change from one vehicle for 12 hours to 60 seconds? Can anybody tell me? Or maybe all of us, you can give me. There are maybe n number of reasons for that.
Process automation?
Process automation, absolutely.
Correct.
What else?
Robots are used for certain processes, sir.
Robots were used for the certain, absolutely. Yes. Very true. The
press machine which is used to cut the sheet metal, that also is with high capacity and speed is also high.
Correct. So the feeding system, the feeding automation. Very true.
Right.
Correct. What else? So these are all different types of options and the opportunities were utilized to bring that 12 hours to 60 seconds. Okay. At the same time, number of people, what they were using and what they were involved into that, that has been reduced to the minimum number. The operator dependency. The moment we have seen, if there is a continuous types of jobs are there and the operator is working, we have taken example of that Charlie Chaplin example, he gets bored up. It's for us also actually. If the routine basis work is there, we are going to get bored up actually, right? So the input and output is pertaining to the process, and the process is the technical process, then we are going to get the results in terms of the automation, in terms of the productivity increase by doing a production, by reduction into the manpower. I will be reducing the manpower dependency over there, right? So this is typical engineering thought process actually. How do engineer works actually? They like to have the, normally science people, they will be working a little differently than the engineers actually. We would like to utilize the wheels. We do not want to reinvent the wheels actually. And the scientist or the science people or the other kind of people, they would be more working onto the acquiring the information and then applying that information. But we as engineers, we are applying the technology. We are applying the science. Applied science is nothing but our major core competencies, right? So the engineers should know that it is the device which will deliver the specific output for the specific input. That is what we have to do that. And this is the beginning of the automation part of it, actually. Whatever maybe the application is required, we should be able to have the two things clearly, input and output. These are the two things we have to get involved into that as engineers, right? Typically, if I say that for the automation, I'm going to make use of the motor. So as a automation engineer or as an engineer, what will be your approach for that? Can anybody tell me? Hello? Can anybody tell me what should be my approach? Whether I would be more concerned about the technical calculations and the selection of the motor, or I should be more concerned about the manufacturing procedure of the motor? This is the question probably.
The technical specifications, I think.
Exactly. As an engineer, we are going to be more concerned about the technical specification and not the manufacturing procedure of the motor. This is the most important perspective. We have to definitely think on this, our mind. And then this will be the beginning for us into the going into the next level, actually. Okay. We also talked about it, the continuous and batch production and whatnot, actually, the process of under discrete manufacturing and all. That's the reason I gave the example of typically the Ford motors, actually. Initial stage, one madam also did mention that it takes almost 3 to 4 months or 6 months of time frame for the development of a particular car in the initial, right from the concept. Okay, that's very true. I would like to give an example, actually. Now, we have been talking about it, this Ola two-wheeler. Have you heard of it, Ola? What is doing Ola, actually? Hello?
It's a service providing industry, one can say that.
Okay, that is Ola is a service providing. Now, one more Ola model or one more Ola company has come into this market, actually. Do you know what is that?
Electric vehicle, I think.
EV, correct. Electric vehicles, actually. Yes. So where is that plant now? That plant is in Tamil Nadu, near Krishnagiri. Okay. And they have promised us that you should be able to start getting the electric vehicles or the electric operated or battery operated two-wheeler within a span of next 2 months. How enough you got it? Hello? Vikas Patil sir. Vikas Patil sir.
46.
Patil sir, can you just please, hello? Thank you. How many of you have seen the vehicles on the road now? Very few vehicles are on the road, actually. So usually, I deliberately give this example as rightly pointed out by madam few minutes back, that it's going to take more and more time over there. Okay, so in the initial stage, the prototype building or the preliminary building of the equipment, and once this product has been established, this is typically product life management. This is typically PLM. We have been talking about it, right? So the moment we build up the prototype, we do not require to go for the automation. We do not require to go for what is our aim? Our aim is to initiate, establish the product, develop the product, and put it into the market. As the production increases, as the demand increases, we need to plan for the typical product development or the productivity increase into that. Okay, so this is a very important phase of any product development cycle, and this defines the requirements of automation. This defines the type of production one has to adopt for that. So for any kind of automation, we will have to have the absolute clarity in such kind of things over there, right? So there are different continuous production in the process industries, continuous production in the discrete manufacturing, batch production, and the batch production in the discrete manufacturing industries. So these are different forms of the manufacturing processes which are being utilized while defining the automation part of it over there. So what is meant by automation directly? Automation is a technology connected with the application of mechanical, electronics, computer, or electrical-based systems to operate and control the production. We have seen one example. We have seen one example of typically assembly line for the car. But that is not only the thing. We have got N number of industrial applications where we have been seeing the automation. Typically, I will give if the mechanical engineers are here or the mechanical professors, they would be remembering their olden days where the lathe is there, milling machine is there. And that has been utilized for converting the metal into the parts, actually, right? Now, nowadays, when today we are going into the industry, we are finding that all these conventional machines are being replaced with the CNC or the VMC machines. Why? The requirements have changed. The production requirement have modified. The productivity norms have changed. The safety norms have changed, right? So the automatic machine tools for the process parts, automatic assembly machines, industrial robots, everybody has mentioned about this, actually. right? The automatic material handling and storage, ASR bolt, we talk about ASR about it, ASRS, automatic inspection systems, the feedback control and the computer control systems and whatnot. All these things are forming a typical part of the industrial automation. The distinctive feature of the engineering science tells us that the human being is the very important perspective for controlling the manufacturing process. Okay, this is very important, the human being. And what are those sensory part of a human being which are being used into the industry actually? Can anybody tell me? Hello? Can anybody tell me this particular, what are the parts which are very important for the human being? Which
are used eyes and hearing skill.
Absolutely, eyes. Yeah. Yes, very true. Eyes. What else actually?
Ears.
Correct. That is also a sensor actually. Because if I see there is a wrong noise coming from the machine, then I will be little more converse with, I will be asking my maintenance people, hey, look at it. The motor is giving a noise. Correct. Very true. What else is there?
Tongue, skin.
Yes, tongue is also there. I'm instructing to the people. I'm instructing to the machines. It's something like that. Very true. Somebody just mentioned about a skill. The skill are being translated from through what? You work with your own hands.
Hand-eye coordination.
The synchronization, isn't it? So typically, I'm just considering this as a typical part of it. And that's what I'm talking about it as the important elements for the automation. When in the absence of automation, in the absence of a more this thing, the human is doing the job of automation, isn't it? And he has been trying to understand, evaluate all these parts. He is going to, engineers use the standardized and therefore the international understood description tools, most of which are graphical actually, right? As an engineer, our language is the drawing, our language is the graph. Our language is the presentation. All our engineers, we have been working in that fashion actually, right? And they are not but the flowcharts, the programs, technical plans, and the schematic diagram, engineering parts, part list, and all these things. These are all the elements we have been part and parcel of the process actually, right? And just a moment back, we talked about the different kinds of human sensors we have been using, the human sensors like eye, ears, tongue, isn't it? And all these things are being utilized for the process validation. All these things are used for establishing a process. Now, in the similar manner, if I say that, if I want to replace a human being, so what are those things I should be able to consider? Can anybody tell me? If I want to replace a human being, just take the example of the very first example, video clipping we have seen. What is that? I have given the answer itself now actually. What are the sensors we have to use in place of human being actually? The cinematic. Can anybody tell me?
Yes, sir. Proximity sensors, correct. Vision, proximity. Cameras.
Yes.
Switches.
Vision system is the camera.
Limit switches,
correct. Right.
And output side, electrical actuators, hydraulic.
Actuators, right.
And controller, that is mainly PLC.
Yes. Correct. So the brain, the coordination work will be done by the controllers, right? So in short, if I want to replace the human being, I need to have all such kind of parts which are going to be the integral part of the human being and which will be programmed, which will be planned, which will be executed, executing the desired function, right? So automation technology is a crossover discipline that uses knowledge and scientific methods from numerous other technical senses, that is sensors to detect the system states, actuators to output the control commands, and controllers for program flow and to make the decisions. Am I right? So the automation technology is a crossover discipline. This is a very important point. And as per the DIN standard 19223, DIN basically is the German standards. They are the very prominent people who have established the basic fundamental processes for the automation and the artificial systems, which can be decisions based useful for us actually. Okay, in India, we are not very well aware about all these things, but in Europe or in the America, they have been very specifically talking about these kind of things over there. So the specific output I can directly replace with the human being with this automation system. This is the point I would like to emphasize over there. But does that has got the more benefits also for us actually? As a human being and as an automation system or the sensors part of it, is there any difference? Can anybody tell me? Is there any difference for that actually?
Yes, sir. They are more accurate.
Correct.
As far as accuracy is concerned, they are more accurate. Even they can be converted into some other signal, maybe electrical signals. Signal.
Correct.
Like
that. Correct. Correct. But what is that advantage with the being a human being actually? Can my PLC or can my robot take
the human being will be immediate decision making will be there, which
exactly.
is not logical functions. Immediate functions will not be performed by the machineries.
Correct. Exactly. So there are always pros and cons with the automation system when we have been going for that, and we should be able to keep it in mind. What is that? We must be able to have the relative strengths of the human and relative strengths of the machineries actually, or the automation point of view, right? So I cannot be eliminating the manual labor from the production system. Please keep it in mind. Nobody can remove the manual labor system from the production system. The relative strength of the human, the sense unexpected stimuli, they can sense that, right? They can develop the new solutions to the problem. The robots cannot develop the problems on their own. Good. They cope up with the abstract problems. As you rightly mentioned, if anything comes up, quickly you can change that procedure and adopt the appropriate system so that you can reach to the solution for that, right? So they are able to adopt the changes quickly, generalize from the observations. For the automation systems or for the machines, it is everything has to be standardized. Everything has to be normal format. If anything comes as abnormal, then you are going to have the machine stoppage or you are going to get the machine problem, right? So learn from the experience. The human being can learn from the experience. Oh, I have made this mistake. Okay, if I just try to avoid that, then I will be able to reach out to the destination quickly. So this is one very important perspective. And it makes a difficult decisions based on the incomplete data. The machine requires a complete data and then machine can take the call. Whereas as a human being, based on our perception, based on our inputs, we can take the decisions even with the incomplete data. Just example, I thought that we would be able to generate the teams and all. I had planned everything from that perspective actually. Okay. I had planned it from the perspective of forming a different teams and the teams will be working over here and I'll be. But when I realized that, oh, there is not possible, it is not feasible, then I have to change my entire procedure part of it. This could happen with the human being, but this will not happen with the fully automated system or the automation part of it. These are the limitations one has to take. Similarly, to perform repetitive tasks consistently. We have seen into the first film, the operator will get fatigue, but robot will not get fatigue. He will be continuously working. Store large autonomous amounts of data. The human memory has got a limitations actually. Howsoever, maybe we say that I'm a very strong memory backup and all, but you cannot remember maybe half an hour or 2 hours back what exactly happened, but machine can remember that. Okay. Retrieve the data from the memory reliably, readily. This is the very important. I want to scratch my head if I want to remember what I did during that time actually. You know, that's not the case with the machines actually. The perform multiple tasks at a time, the multitasking, multi-skilling. Of course, the human being, we have been talking about multi-skilling, multitasking. Always we have been talking about it, but still it has got a limitation. Apply high forces and power. The human being has got a limitation for that. So all these points are coming into this. So I cannot eliminate the manual labor from the production system. Please keep it in mind. Now, one important aspect of it is also there. What is the impact of the automation on the people? Can anybody tell me? Hello?
Unemployment.
Unemployment, yes. As a result of the automation, there will be unemployment. Partially, I will be saying yes. We have just seen that manual labor from the production system cannot be removed. So can there be the multiplication of the repetitiveness for the non-availability of manpower and all? It will be there. We will discuss over the period of time. What else?
Less fatigue.
Less fatigue. Yes, absolutely. Fatigue will be less. Any other point?
More accuracy and repetitive jobs are more.
Absolutely. Repetitive jobs will be done more accurately. We have seen that if the human is doing the same repetitive job, he is likely to forget certain things. He is likely to, whatever the things are there, he will be thinking something differently. If he has fought with his wife, he will be forgetting further more things over there. That operator will not be missing certain parts. And that will be costing very heavy for all of us. The cost of forgetfulness, isn't it? But that won't be possible with the automation. Okay, what else would be there?
Job can be completed within the cycle time.
Yes, cycle time. Because we have seen, it took almost 12 hours or the 15 hours to build one car. And today we are building the car in 60 seconds. Every 60 seconds we are able to produce one car, right? What else? So, fewer staff are needed for the automated production. This is very important. Less people, less number of people. But this doesn't mean that we are going to get rid of the human being. Human will be replaced by the machines, but at the same time, machine cannot be fully replaced by the human. Other way around, actually. The human will be doing little more better work than the machines, actually. The production can run round the clock. Except for a few maintenance interval periods. And that's where the terminology of uptime or downtime of the machines are being talked in the industry. Then the machine generally makes fewer mistakes, which means the quality of the products are consistently high. The processing times are shortened. We have already discussed all these points. Everything has been put it in the effective manner. Automation relieves the people of boring, physically heavy or hazardous work. The operator safety, this is a very important perspective. We have been talking about it, right? One of the main reasons for the introduction of automation system was to remain the desire to be able to produce the good at a less expensive way, isn't it? We have been talking about it. The as we employ more number of people, the cost of production will be more. And nowadays, when we have been talking about it, the productivity increase, as the production increases, the cost of manufacturing will be reduced. We have been seeing, observing this into Chinese products actually. China, why China has gone to the very prominent into the manufacturing phase actually? Can anybody tell me? Hello? Why China has succeeded into this low cost production?
Mass production.
Mass production, correct. Why mass production is possible to achieve? They have adopted automation.
Yes.
Simple. Okay. So what are the reasons for automating now? Can anybody tell me? We have just discussed right now. I'm just trying to put it over there. Simple. The very first one is to increase the productivity, right? With the automation, we are going to increase the productivity. We want to get rid of the high cost labor. Nowadays, typically, I would like to give an example. We have got a joint venture with a German company as well as one American company, two different locations, right? In Germany, the standard man hour rate for the skilled labor is around 55 euro. 55 euro. If we consider 90 rupees per euro, or for the sake of calculation, 80 rupees per euro, you can imagine more than 4,000 rupees per hour they are paying for the human being. Whereas in India, we have been paying about less than a euro. Our standard man hour rate per day for the skilled manpower is about 700 rupees for 8 hours, or 800 rupees, or roughly 100 hours per hour for the skilled manpower. So I just want to give the examples of this kind of things over here. So how cost of this production is going to be very heavy, very high. And that's one of the reason why European products are very expensive for us, because the kind of manpower, a kind of automation, they have been using it over there. And that's one of the reason that they have been using the automation as the focal area. And probably that's another reason why Germany is a very prominent player for the automation and mechatronics industries for us actually, right? So the high cost of the labor is to be addressed by us. Nowadays, labor shortage is there. Today in my industry, I'm not able to find it out the right type of labor charges, labor or the human being. So then I will prefer to go for the automated systems over there, right? So labor shortage is another reason for which we are going to use that. Trend of labor toward the service sector. Today, we can see that most of the people or most of the youngsters wants to go and work for the service industry. They would like to go for the IT sector. They would like to go for the shopping malls. In the industry, you are able to get about 10 to 12,000 rupees, but you have to utilize your 8 or 10 hours into the industry into the harsh environment. Whereas you can get the same kind of salary if you are going to work into the shopping malls. You will be getting 10,000, 12,000 rupees, but you will be working into the air-conditioned rooms. You will be working without much of effortlessly, actually, probably. So trend of labor towards the service sector is also one of the reasons for achieving or going for the automation. Safety, human safety is another aspect of it. High cost of the raw materials. The same reason we checked about the productivity has been increased by the Chinese market producers by way of the, at the cost of automation, so that the cost of product material, it becomes irrelevant for them. in the constituents for the productivity and production will be considered from that perspective actually. So improved product quality, reduced manufacturing lead time. This is what just now we have mentioned, also somebody has mentioned over there. Reduction of in-process inventory and high cost of not automating. So these are some of the reasons for which we have been talking about it. Automation, adopting the automations part of it. For and against, we have been also talking about it for. Somebody did mention that it is going to take away the jobs. Automation is going to take away. So one of the member just mentioned that that will reduce our manpower's job response opportunities and all. So arguments against automation is automation will result in the subjugation of the human being by a machine. There will be a reduction in the labor force with resulting unemployment, and automation will reduce the purchasing power. These are the things which has been talked against the automation. Whereas for in favor of automation, lot many more points are there. Automation is the key of the shorter work week. Automation brings safer working conditions for the workers. Automated production results in the lower prices and better products. The growth of the automation industry will itself provide employment opportunities. And automation is the only means for increasing our standard of living. Do you agree with me? By yes, adopting yes. automation, we are able to do all these things. Yes, please. Yes, madam.
Yes, sir, we agree with you, sir. Yes. Hello.
Now, coming back to the specific point of the automation will reduce the job opportunities for the laborers, job opportunities for the workers. Is it true?
Because
no, correct. Exactly. So
no,
sir, this
no.
misconceptions has to be cleared by us in the mindset of the people actually, right? Because whenever the machines, new machines are coming up, the human being which are being involved into that will be required to upgrade their skill set. And that's what will be taken up by some another colleagues into next sessions actually over there. Maybe Industry 4.0, maybe for the productivity and production for the industrial productions and all those kind of subjects, they will be taken over there actually, right? I will not be going into more details into that. This also, again, we talked about it, the fixed automation, programmable automation, and the flexible automation. These are the three different types of automations which are being used into the industries actually. When there is a product, more number of quantities required, we are going for the fixed automation. When there is a combination is there, actually, I want to make so many number of these pieces and I want to go for this kind of different types of combinations over there, then I would be going for the flexible automation. And when I want to have the major into the manual productions, I want to depend, the processes are to be produced or adopted for the specific type of applications, then I'll be using the manual productions into that, right? That is the fixed automation actually. So in short, the programmable, and the, you should be able to be little aware about it and give this insight to the students also actually. I will be little quickly going through this, the fixed automation definition. The fixed automation is a system in which the sequence of processing or assembly operations is fixed by the equipment. I've taken some of the examples over there, which will clarify you over there. The high internal investment for the initial investment for the customer will be there. High production rates, of course, it can produce n number of pieces per time actually, and relatively inflexible to accommodate the product change. I will typically give an example of that. If an automobile manufacturer is producing a particular type of model, and if he wants to change the model and use the same assembly line, is it possible for him to do that? No. He will have to do major changes into that. to accommodate the change into that. This was the situation a few years back. Now, because of the Industry 4.0 and the automation flexibility or the IIoT and all, we as a users can interact with the manufacturing systems and place the order and get the system done from them. So this kind of flexibility is possible to achieve with the help of the automation part of it. Okay. The programmable automation is another part of it. High investment in general, but the low production rate would be possible into that. The flexibility to deal with the changes in production configuration. This is very, I was just referring to that. Nowadays, if I want to place an order for the BMW with my own requirements and all, I can go to the online. I select the car. I will select the interior of that and then place the order just by clicking my payment. Then within a span of 8 days or 10 days, I'll be able to get my dream car as per my requirement. This is the impact and importance of the programmable automation, actually. This is a very important perspective we should be able to keep in mind. The most suitable for the batch production. So that particular type of models will be produced maybe 500 pieces or maybe 200 pieces. Typical example, if you have seen the production productivity plan for the BMW in Chennai, I think some of your members are from Chennai have attended this. If you have seen, can anybody tell me what is the difference there at the conventional assembly lines? Hello? Typically, they are producing the Mini or the Q3 or the different types of models in a day. In a daily, there is a changeover happening over there because of the entire assembly line is a programmable automation kind of thing. It is a flexible possible. This flexibility is possible for them. But at the same time, if I want to make it more flexible, then the cost of this is again going to be very high, but it is flexibility to deal with the product in designs variations. And that's one of the example I would like to give it to the second video clipping, what we have seen it over there, that during the Second World War, they were able to convert their assembly line into the assembly line for aircraft.
Yes, sir.
This is the most important thing I wanted to remember by all of you, actually. It means the progress and the process of the manufacturing assembly lines have been switched from a fixed to the flexible and the variable kind of things over there, because that is the need, that is the demand of the hour, actually, isn't it? So when the variety of things are there, then we should be able to go for the programmable automation. When not much of varieties are there, then we can go for the fixed automation. Okay. When the more number of quantity is there, then we have to go for the fixed automation. When there is a more programmable or the varieties and less quantities are there, then we can go for the programmable automation. Nowadays, this change is happening very rapidly. And I must be able to tell you that this requirement is changing the mode of automation. This changing the desire for the automation part of it. Okay. So production operations and the strategies. This is another aspect of which we should be able to talk a little bit about it. Production is a transformation process that converts raw material into the products. Okay. We have seen it in the first or second slide itself. We have seen it over there. Now, the products are made by a combination of manual labor, machinery, tools, and energy. Whereas the transformation is the process usually involves a sequence or the steps or the stages. Just somebody mentioned that for the development of a car, one has to take about 3 to 5 months or 6 months also. In your colleges also, when the students are coming out with the project requirements, and if somebody is building the two-wheeler or four-wheeler, you must have seen that, how much kind of efforts they have to take it over there, isn't it? So the transformation takes a very important perspective for them, and the production operations are required to be set up over the period of time over there, right? And owing to the competitive pressures in the market, a company often needs to introduce a new product in the shortest span period. What will happen if suppose I'm going to take more time? I will give the example of typically, example would be that the same thing, Ola two-wheeler. They have taken about almost 3 months, they have delayed to enter into the market. And that has helped many small players to penetrate into the Indian market. If you have seen the two-wheelers, auto electric two-wheelers, I'm talking about it. They have been able to enter this market very rapidly. In place like Nasik, place like Pune, place like Chennai, the people are eagerly waiting for the Ola to bring their vehicles, but still many people are opting to go for the TVS make two-wheelers, or they are going for the XYZ company make. I do not remember the name of the manufacturers and all, but you will find many more small players are entering into the market. So this is the strategies one has to remember while entering into the markets over there very quickly actually. Typical automation migration strategy are a very important perspective one has to remember actually. As we said that for the product development part of it, we have been talking about it, the phase one, that is the manual production, the prototype development, manual production, and then bringing it into market, just market checking, feasibility part of it over there. Isn't it? So starting the work part of it over there. So the manual workstation will be converting that into the production by taking the processes into the next level. So the manual production with the single independent workstations. This is the phase one. The phase two is the automated production stations with the manual handling between the stations. And third one, the integrated or the automated integrated production with automated handling between the stations. Isn't it? So these are the different processes and which are being used by the industry, and we will have to keep it in mind over there. So manual production using the single station, manned cells or the operations. I did ask this question, if you remember, while we were just talking about it, the film, the very first film, when the worker is doing the job, and I want to increase the productivity, what is to be done? I can introduce a small automated table or the workstation, that is the manual production part of it, isn't it? Then I can think of adopting the automated production with the intermediate procedures adopting over there. So that is my automated production of workers, and the machines will be interfacing with each other. And third one is nothing but the automated integrated production. Just now we have seen it over there. That will be going into the next level very quickly and effectively and efficiently for that. That's what we call as automated integrated production. I've just taken an example of typically a rubber components is manufactured by metal to rubber bonding. All the automobile sector has got more than 30% such components are which are made out of rubber or metal or plastic or engineering plastics and all. Okay, so I would be considering this as a manual production workers when initially they have been operated by a human being over there. Okay, they are applying with the brush. As the number of quantities started increasing, they started adopting the different processes that is called as the spray processes actually. So this is the manual production or the phase one. When the automated, the number of this process started increasing, they started adopting it, some kind of process automation on the mechanism. Mechanism was adopted on the fixturing, they started mounting it, and instead of putting it by the human being, some mechanism was introduced over there. Try to remember the word mechanism. And that really helped them in establishing the process in a very quicker way, quickly. typically, when this was reached to the next level, then still, now in the first manual labor process, they had maybe 8 to 10 women or 8 to 10 workers. They are applying, taking the brush, applying it to the components. Now, with this automated machine, the second one, what we just now saw, we have been able to get rid of that 8-10 people. Only one person will be able to operate the machine, and the machine will be doing the jobs. Okay. Another thing is that in the process, we need to do a lot many operations into that. I need to apply the coating, then apply the, put it into the heating so that it will be heated, dried. After drying, I need to apply another coat. So this entire automatic process is being replaced, and wherein we need to use the people for handling the component from one station to another station, or maybe we'll have to produce or provide some kind of automation systems in between, and which can take care of the process actually. So here, the process has been fully automated, wherein the system can be used by a single operator and translate to all the operations over there. I would like to ask a couple of questions based on this over there. Please have a effective look at this video. Okay, I think you have understood the entire process of this actually, fully automated integrated coating conductor, right?
That is.
So what are your observations? I would like you to mention about it. I want you to just tell me about it. What are your observations over there? Have you been able to go through that? Have you been able to see that operations completely? I know that I don't want to you to get me all the everything together, but maybe what you have observed, I want to have. Hello.
Yes, sir. There is a continuous process with some batch quantity.
Correct. Okay.
And previously there was a coating of the coating of those bushes.
Yes.
And then next operation, there were some gears or some automated small parts in a batch, and they are being cleaned with the maybe air jet or like that way.
Exactly. Right. Hello, your voice is feeble. Any other?
Very less human intervention.
Yes, very less human intervention actually. Coating of batch bushes with automated spray jets. Perfect. Mr. Gill, right. Very true. Any other observation? How many different types of components or how many different types of elements you have been able to identify over here actually? System-wise, actually.
Pneumatic components. Pneumatic cylinder and tubings.
Correct. Pneumatic cylinders. The pneumatic system is there, right? Okay. What else is there? Yes, pneumatic cylinder is there. What else is there?
Chain and sprocket.
Chain sprocket. That is a for the transfer purpose. There is a transmission system is also there, right? Okay. What else is there? Have you seen the AGV? Have you seen the AGV there actually? Auto guided vehicle AGV.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
While pallet has been transferred from one location to another location, taken into the next level, that will be transferred by the AGV. Right? How many of you have seen that robot there actually? Have you seen the robot? There is a gantry robot into that. The gantry robot is applying the spray. The painting is been done by the gantry robot actually. Okay. There is a W axis has been achieved with the help of indexer. Okay. There are stoppers. So what I want to give a emphasis over here, the more we go into the automation, more we go to the automated integrated applications and all, we have to give a thrust on a system engineering perspective. The automation or the mechatronics and the system engineering goes very much hand in hand. And this particular approach is very much missing into our education system, which I want to emphasize over here. I want you to give a little more thought on this particular perspective and try to transfer this particular insight to your students over there. Okay. Let's go to the next. Similar, one more example actually. Here, typically the example is that I want to do the cleaning of tubes from inside. And the cleanliness is required to the tune of about 10 microns of the particle size. Particle size cleanliness required is about 10 microns. So this particular typical example, I have shown it over here. So what are your observations? What are the systems there into that now?
Pneumatics.
Sorry?
Pneumatics.
Pneumatic gripper is there.
Yes, clamping. Pneumatic grippers are there, right? What else is there? Hello? What is that yellow one? Yellow kind of things. What is that? there is a water circulation system, there is a brushing system though there actually. Okay, so invariably you will be able to find some mechanism from up and down. Okay, some mechanism for rotating the brush, wire brush or brush part of it. Okay, then the safety curtains are there. So all these such kind of elements will be forming the integral part of any automation system, and then it will have the process of the system engineering approach, which will be establishing the success or failure of that particular process system actually. Okay, another example I would like to give it over here. This is the tube handling automation for the grinding lines. The same product, okay, the same tube is now required to be applied for the grinding process. Grinding is required to be carried out with the two stages. One first stage is the rough grinding and second is the coarse grinding. So you can imagine the two different grinding machines are there, and then in the absence of such automation, what one has to do is that one has to use two separate operators and one person for handling of that. So now that has been replaced with this kind of automation. This is the loader. And automatic loading and unloading is also possible in this particular kind of machine. The simple mechanism, simple systems, I'm trying to give the example so that you will be able to remember and recollect the importance of the processes and the steps which are involved into this automation system actually. Okay. So what are the things you have seen over there? It's very simple, simplest form actually. Can anybody tell me what are the things you have seen here?
Conveyor,
correct. Conveyor is there for transfer handling. What else is there?
Pick and place mechanism
is also there, right? Transfer system or the pick and place. Yes. What else is there? Again, I'm starting. Some sensors are there, right? Sorry.
Yes, sir.
Oh. So after sensor does sense that, it will be giving a signal for the further loader, for the loading purpose, right?
Loading sensor.
The sequential operation is being controlled by the PLC, but the signal is given by a sensor. Typically, I'm giving the example, what will happen if in the absence of sensor, the operator, what will he will do? He will see that, okay, this tube has gone to the grinding line now, and I need to feed the second thing. So I will just pull that particular part and put it into the conveyor or put it into. So all these operations will be carried out by a sensor, by a conveyor and the integrated approach. So this integrated approach is also going to be the very important part. Now here is the cross handling of the tubes again. Now there are two different machines. I cannot be keeping the two machines on the same locations actually. So in such a cases, one has to do the cross linking, cross handling typically. This is also handling, this is also transfer. There's a pusher and it goes into the next line actually. It means that component which has come from the rough grinding, it will be going to the for the final grinding or the finish grinding in this particular level. So we call it the intermediate conveyors actually, intermediate handling line. Typical example I gave it over there. Then the unloading and stacking. Usually after the loading, after the job. Now you can see how many number of people I am able to save with the help of this particular, and then this will be deciding the cost of the investment and the return on investment. So any automation, we have to talk about it, ROI considerations. Okay. Here. The jobs are coming after finish, after Sir, grinding, and that will be loaded into the stack. stacker actually. This is the stacker actually, which can be taken up by the operator as and when required. Now, the most important perspective for anybody, for any kind of automation, one has to think of is the return on investment perspective. And this return on investment perspective will be worked out based on your investments into that. So the automation principle, USA, is another aspect of it. Understand the requirement, simplify the requirement, and do the automation. This is the USA principle, which one has to keep it in mind while designing the or working out with the systems actually. So input-output analysis has to be done very perfectly. Value chain analysis has to be done, and charting techniques and the mathematical modeling will help you in understanding the system in a more effective manner. Simplify the process and then automate. This is the very important thing. One has to keep it in mind. I think here I would like to stop automation strategies on the subject is a very big, but if anybody has got any questions, please ask me. Thank you. It seems that I have been able to transfer the most of my knowledge to the everybody in a very effective manner because there is no questions. That's good. So I'm good. I can be a good teacher then. Rather than an industry person, I can be a good teacher. Am I right? Borse sir?
Yes, sir. Certainly, sir. Sure.
I hope all the 60 participants, 61 participants right now have understood the topic. Effectively, they are able to grab the, and they are happy, rather they have been able to get something while they go home today.
Yes, sir. Definitely, sir.
Any questions?
It was, sir, excellent session given by you. And you have interacted with all of us, means made us actively involved. That was so nice of you. And a great session. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Nihal madam. Yeah. Other
it
people?
Was very good to watch our observation skill also. We have to watch those videos carefully so that we can understand what are the elements in that automation system and we get to know the systems that
very true. Yes. Yes, absolutely. Yes. What is the takeaway from all of you, actually? What is the takeaway from this session, actually? Yes, as rightly Mr. Borse has mentioned that you have to be carefully see what to see and what not to see. I always say that we must be able to do the reading between the lines. The person, the orator or the writer is trying to tell you something. You must be able to take what exactly you want to have it over there, right? And as a teacher, as a professor, This is a very important perspective and insight for all of us, actually. Anybody else?
Yes, anyone? Hello. So good afternoon, all. I am Professor Ganesh Vag, and I'm here to present vote of thanks for today's session. On the behalf of Guru Gobind Singh Polytechnic, I would like to thank our guest, Honorable Mr. Ravindra Mahadevkar, sir, for enlightening us with your knowledge. The session was full of knowledge and interesting things, sir. It gave a deep insight into the topic and revealed very interesting things. I am sure this knowledge will be help us in our future. At the same time, I am very thankful to all participants for the patience and interactive participation. Thank you so much, sir. Seriously, the session was very informative and this will be help us a lot.
Still 15 minutes are there. If anybody wants to have any insight about it, please free to ask the questions. Otherwise, of course, it's an informal way now. As Professor Vag has already concluded the session, now this is the informal session is there. If anybody wants to have how to ask, what to ask, and now you are welcome.
Sir, Can I ask you one small favor that do you deliver sessions to other polytechnic students, like our polytechnic third year students? Can you deliver a session? In that case, can I have your mail ID, sir?
Yes, you can have the mail ID, definitely. In fact, actually, I'm not a teacher. But I like to share my views. I like to share the express different topics, because as an industry person, I am the person who faces a lot of challenges from the input from institutions, actually, okay? From the engineering colleges or polytechnics, whenever the student comes over there, I'm the first person to face the music, actually. So I always would like to enlighten, I always would like to translate or transfer the necessary input to people like you, actually. And that's how I'm just sharing with you, actually. But yes, yes, sir, definitely I've been helping, yeah.
Yes, sir. As a my point of view, whatever the methodology you have adopted towards explaining this basic automation things to all of us, that again, very much simple, and this going to get touch to the audience, so that they are completely interactive, involved, and certainly we can take away some of the things like the, which are the basic automation, like the programmable, fixable, fixed, where it is to apply, where it is to be changed or transformation from one to another, like the Second World War example you have already given. So fixed to the programmable or the flexible. And whatever the short videos you have shown us towards the identifying the components, suppose when we wanted to share or teach such a topic to the student, we certainly show the list or the photographs to the components, and yes, these are the components and these are used in the automation and like this. But I truly appreciate, sir, the way you have conducted the session. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. I got one question from Mr. Cham Kumar Singh Gill, actually. Can you just put on your camera, or your camera is not on? Mr. Gill, your question is very nice, actually. Automation and artificial intelligence, how they differ, can it be in the in use same stream? Absolutely. Artificial intelligence or automation is the rather artificial intelligence is the extension of the automation, actually. As we while discussing, I described that human being is being utilized, its sensory elements. That's your eyes, your tongue or ears, right? Then you use your brain while delivering certain processes part of it over there. Likewise, the artificial intelligence is also a typical part of it. And unfortunately or fortunately, there are lot many things which are not very clear to the science also about it for the brain, actually. So artificial intelligence is a wide open topic, especially for the automation people or the automation kind of human being, which will be really exploring the different perspective is an essential thing for them. So it is very, very much in the same stream, actually. Have I answered your question? Thank you. Okay. Okay, I'll be writing my email ID, ravi.mahadevkar. That's Trauma Summit. So those who wants to have, they can have it. I'm also writing my, and of course, my company name.
Yeah.
I got about three different companies. One is my, which I started. And since there is about 5 minutes more before there are no questions, I'm just briefing about it. I started this company, Summit Engineers and Consultant Private Limited, about 25 years back, my own. And which was like an automation company only. 25 years back, I had a dream of being into the automation part of it. So I had a whatever the automation requirements. That time, this kind of structured approach was not there into the industries actually. So I used to do whatever the things I used to get a requirement. And eventually, in about 10 years back, I got the first joint venture with a German company. That's where we have been talking about it, the Strama Summit Machinery. That's now, right, we have been showing, which is engaged into the automated assembly lines. And this is one of the first three companies in the worldwide market who is mainly engrossed into the automated assembly lines. So we are the youngest company into that group. This is a joint venture between Strama MPS and Summit. About 30% we belongs and 70% belongs to them. So that's how I started more and more involved into that, this technological perspective and the approaches, what we have been talking right now over there. And that really helped me in grooming my team also, actually. So that, for grooming my people, I have established the finishing school concept into my company. And that is now today, it's called as the Automation Nund Mechatronics Finishing School, AUM, which is available for all the students. Anybody can come and utilize that infrastructure. I did spend about more than 50 lakhs rupees those days. Today, it's valuation wise, it is much, much more, wherein we have got all the robots and everything into that. And of course, we have got another joint venture with the American company. That's about 1.5 years back. And this factory we have got in Kolhapur. This is a 100% subsidiary for St. Clair Systems, US. And that's how we have got about 3-4 different companies. Every company is engaged into the automation and mechatronics in the field of automation part of it. So anybody wants to have any kind of support, please, we can be, we'll be happy to support on that. Chalo, it's almost 3 o'clock. The time is over for all of you. We'll be able to have some break before you attend another session part of it.
Once again, thank you very much, sir, for your valuable knowledge. I would like to request all the participants to please turn on your camera. We will have the photo with honorable guest. So everyone, please turn on your camera so that we can have the group photo with sir.
Yeah, definitely. I would like to have the group photo, at least that privilege. At least I was not able to interact with you.
కాంటాక్ట్ నెంబర్ ఉందా అది ఓకే సార్ ఉందా
అగైన్ ఇఫ్ పాసిబుల్ ఎవ్రీవన్ ప్లీజ్ టర్న్ ఆన్ యువర్ కెమెరా yes done thank you very much everyone and attendance and feedback link is available in the chat box participants are requested to mark the attendance once again thank you so much sir for your valuable knowledge and
welcome
things are very much interesting for us thank you very much and one announcement is there for all the participants our next session will be start at 3:15 p.m. So it's requested to join the session on time. Thank you very much. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. All the best for everybody. Bye.
Thank you, sir.